Hi, so I was doing a little job on my Freelander today, changing the camshaft sensor. And for a long while, I thought it'd be useful to have a torque wrench that measures very low values of torque for these sort of bolts, like the camshaft cover on this K-series engine. And never went out and bought one, but for the first time ever, somebody's actually sent me a free tool to review. Cause for celebration, I suppose. Not being paid to do this video, they just gave me the tool. And after a couple of months, got round to actually reviewing it. Sorry for the delay, guys. Well, let's see if it's any good. So why do I need a tool like this? Well, the torque setting, the official torque for these sort of bolts is 8 Newton meters, which is very low. And this tool is actually ideal for doing these sort of torques. These are already done up, already finished the job. But you can feel as a nice solid action, good click. But is it actually accurate? Let's go and see. So here's the box it came in. It's a very short manual. And what's quite nice to see is a calibration certificate, which says it's been individually tested. These are the actual readings at different torques. Three measurements each. It says at 5 Newton meters set, it actually gives a reading of 5.1 around about Newton meters on actual measurement. Let's see if that's actually true or not. It says the accuracy of the unit is about 4%. That's the precision down here, which I think is good enough. Up until now, the only torque wrenches I've had have been these bendy bar ones, which you can see on the scale there, 5 Newton meters, which is the lower scale. Would be very difficult to read, just one of those small divisions and a friction on this bendy bar would probably make that extra difficult. This one only really starts reading on the scale from about 10. We'll come back to how well that measured 5 Newton meters later. So how do you check the accuracy of a torque wrench? Well, torque is all about force and distance. So for instance, it's measured in pound foot or Newton meters. Pound is like a weight, which is a force, and pound foot is the distance. So if you imagine, well, let's just take this stick I'm going to use. This is actually my torque measuring setup. Anyone can do it. Set of baked bean cans. I've weighed that on my accurate Salter scales. That's 1.888 kilograms, which stacks up with the stated weight of each can. The contents, 415 grams. The can itself is about 50 grams. So four of them is in the right sort of ballpark. My scales are quite accurate. That's the only really thing you need to accurately measure torque. And a tape measure, just to measure the distance between your pivoting point, which we'll come to in a minute. I'm going to use this spanner taped onto this stick, marked off a particular distance to give me the right torque. And that is all you need. And how do we do it? Well, I've got some calculations on the back of the manual written down here. First, we need to see if the stick and the spanner will contribute any turning force. Obviously, it weighs a certain amount of has a certain amount of force that's going to be on it, and at its midpoint, that's the distance away from its pivot point that we need to measure. So the midpoint's about there. That's the pivot point that's going to connect to our torque wrench. And that distance was 16 centimeters. I weighed this stick on my scales, and that's 53 grams. And simple calculation, here we are, stick and spanner, 53 grams. Distance from the midpoint to the end, 16 centimeters. So the torque contribution from the stick, if we measure it in these units, is 16 times 53, 16 centimeters, 53 grams. And as a torque measurements, that'll be 848 gram centimeters. Not an often quoted unit combination, but equally valid for measuring torque. Now, 1 gram of force equals that number of newtons, 0.0098. So the contribution of torque from the stick and spanner in Newton meters is quite negligible. It's actually 0.083 Newton meters. So what I'm going to do is test the calibration of this torque wrench at the stated 5 Newton meters. They measure about 5.1. So if I want 5 Nm, or including the stick calibration, I want to apply a force of 4.92 Nm from a new weight, and my weight is 1.88 kilograms, which equals, if we times by that number, 18.5 newtons. Then the distance we want for 5 Nm turning force at this point on this stick, distance away from the end, that we need to place our 1.88 kilogram weight is 5 Nm divided by 18.5 newtons equals 27 centimeters, and this is the point marked with a pen, 27 centimeters away from the end. So we've got our stick on our baked beans at that point. Then we'll set up like this. Here's our pivot point, resting on something convenient. Happens to be a bag of cement, don't worry about that. Here's our weight, happens to be some baked bean cans, don't worry about that. It's the correct distance away from the end. Doesn't look very professional, nice and amateurish. It's great what you can achieve with some basic stuff around the house. And so what we'll do is turn, we'll put a force on the torque wrench till it's lifting the can, and you can hear it clicking. So we'll turn up the torque wrench setting on the handle so that it doesn't click when we lift that weight, and then with the weight lifted, we'll slightly back it off until we hear the click, and that'll be the point that the torque wrench is measuring that 5 Nm of torque, and we'll see what the reading on the dial is. Do that very slowly. Oh, there we go. Let's see, do a few measurements of that, but let's just see what that reading is. And we have bang on 5.0 Nm. Let's check it out again. Well, there we go. What is it this time? Just over 5, somewhere between 5 and 5.1. One more measurement for luck. And one more. What was that? It is. Yeah, that's about 5.2 maybe. So their measurements are 5.1, seems to be bang on, and my measurement technique also seems to be bang on. So both are quite good. So it shows you can accurately measure torque using baked bean cans and a stick or anything you've got handy, as long as your scales are quite accurate, of course, which I believe mine are. And it's a nice, I think it's a good confirmation, not terribly scientific, because probably need to have my scales calibrated, but certainly everything is in agreement. The fact it agrees with the calibration certificate is good. Quite a nice little tool, made in China, and well, I'll see if I can put some links, some buying links from someone like Amazon perhaps, in the video description. So there we go, a useful tool to add to your toolbox, and something I always meaning to buy. It's got a useful method for locking the torque as well. This little collar here, you turn the handle to select the torque setting you want. You just push that collar up, and that keeps the handle locked in position so that it won't turn anymore as you're using the tool, which is quite nice. So, yep, thank you, Handife. Don't know how you say that word. Handife. Mm. Thank you for sending me that tool, and useful addition to the toolbox. And I nearly forgot to mention, I did a similar torque measurement at the 5 Nm level with those weights on these torque wrenches. So on here, not really meant to use it below about 10 Nm, but that 5 Nm torque measured at about 3 on this one, so not terribly accurate. And this one, it was difficult seeing the needle actually move. Did a little bit, but again, very inaccurate. So it is quite useful to have a new torque wrench to measure and set those low torque values. And the very last thing to mention is, before you put the torque wrench away, always back it off to zero or under zero on the torque setting. That avoids putting the internal spring under constant compression, possibly pushing it out of calibration over the coming years. Okay guys, thanks for watching. There will be some more Freelander fixing videos coming soon, as well as some others. Haven't done any in a while because I've been busy on a patio project, which is taking absolutely ages. That little project over there, subject probably of another video at some point. Thanks for watching. Bye.